Blueberries are on the top 10 list of healthiest foods, and I'm here at the North Carolina Research Campus in Kannapolis to find out why. I am the produce lady, and I'm in the lab of Dr. Mary Ann Lila. Dr. Lila is the director of the NC State University Plants for Human Health Institute. She is an international blueberry expert. In fact, she's been called the rock star of blueberry research. Dr. Lila, tell us about your research and why this tiny fruit is so good for us.
Well, all fruits and vegetables are good for you. I'll start with that. But berries are really in a class by themselves, and in particular this class of berries that includes the blueberries, because they have such a complex natural chemistry. A series of compounds that are important for human health. When you consume the blueberry, they interact with human therapeutic targets. They are anti-inflammatory and antioxidant. And through these mechanisms, they're able to combat cardiovascular disease, diabetes, neuroprotection. So they actually have efficacy against Parkinson's disease and Alzheimer's disease. So they are neuroprotective. They, when you age, they actually improve motor and cognitive function. Wow. We've done some work also just on the anti-cancer properties of the components in the blueberry. They have such a complex chemistry, and each of these little natural chemicals work together. They potentiate the effect. I think that's what makes a blueberry so powerful compared to so many other berries, because they have such a complex chemistry and these chemicals work together for human health.
I understand that the NC State Plants for Human Health Institute has been the lead agency to sequence the blueberry genome. Can you tell us more about the significance of this research and how that's going to help you?
It is very exciting, because every time a plant makes a chemical that's important for human health or for other purposes, that chemical is controlled by a gene. When we can understand the gene sequence, we can understand best how to produce the chemical, how to breed for a better plant, how to utilize that. And this project is being led by Dr. Alan Brown in the Plants for Human Health Institute, but it is because the blueberry is a complex little berry with a complex genome and a complex chemistry. It's a challenging project. This is not some simple model organism that we can sequence. We are really taking advantage of the stellar, state-of-the-art instrumentation that we have here at this campus to do this very complex, formidable task of sequencing the blueberry genome, and already have made such huge strides in that realm.
So how will Dr. Brown's research on the genome sequence help you with your research?
Well, again, it's a complicated chemistry, so a complicated blueberry genome. What Dr. Brown is discovering is what genes are responsible for which of these chemicals that interact together. They potentiate the effect for human health. They give so much greater an effect than one single compound. So unlike a synthetic drug where there's one substance that inhibits one enzyme and has one effect, this is such a complex, and only through Dr. Brown's deciphering this genome can we really come to grips with how to best produce these chemicals.
Dr. Lila, will you tell us a little more about your work with diabetes and blueberries and what's happening there?
Well, some of the most exciting work that we're doing now is on blueberries and type 2 diabetes. And what we have found using in vitro and animal models is that by feeding a very small amount of blueberries in the daily diet, we're able to reduce blood glucose levels within a 6-hour period better than metformin. Now, metformin is the drug of choice for most diabetics. That's the one that most doctors will prescribe. So we can actually do it more effectively by consuming an easily obtained functional food.
That is so significant and can really mean something to all of us.
Absolutely. And we're also doing work now on concentrating those active compounds in the blueberry in a functional food matrix and excluding all the sugar and water.
Oh, wow.
You know, so people that feel like, oh, well, maybe I'm having too much sugar with my berries, although that's not really true, but people will feel that sometimes, they can actually get it now in a functional food that concentrates it and keeps it intact.
A real power food there.
Real power food.
This is really an exciting new development. So this is a work in process, is that correct?
That's correct. We're now developing a functional food ingredient that's not available on the store shelves yet, but we hope very soon will be, within a year, so that you can buy many different products that would contain blueberry bioactives.
So Dr. Lila, what is your recommendation for us to be consuming every day for our best health?
This is a rough ballpark, mm-hmm. but we recommend about a half a cup a day.
Okay.
And that's easy to do because this berry is so versatile. It need not be in just sweet foods, in cakes and pies. You can use it on salads. You can use it in meats. You can use it in so many different ways. So it's really easy to consume those berries every day.
So if I just get a little handful, a quarter cup, a couple of times a day, mm-hmm. I've got it?
You got it.
I can do that. Thank you.
Your research clearly demonstrates the health protective qualities of blueberries. How often do you consume blueberries?
Oh, at least once a day. And I think that's important because you need to have them in your system all the time, and they're so versatile that it's easy to do.
What are some of your favorite ways to consume blueberries?
Well, one thing that I do every single morning is I'll get up and I'll put about a half a cup of frozen blueberries in the bottom of a bowl and then pour my hot oatmeal over it.
Oh.
Add a little almond milk, maybe a little Ovaltine on top. It doesn't matter what you do after that. But that's so important because the best way to eat a blueberry is either fresh, right, mm-hmm. right off the bush, or right out of the freezer.
And they can be so convenient and easy to use, can't they?
Absolutely.
That's what I love about them. This looks great.
Well, this is another method that I love because it takes advantage of just taking the frozen blueberry, mixing it up with some great ingredients, and getting it in a form that's not cooked, not changed at all.
Mm-hmm.
This is a blueberry salsa.
Mm.
In this case, the blueberries actually replace the tomatoes that are in a normal salsa.
Okay.
And it's a wonderful flavor, melange of onions and peppers and cilantro and a little bit of cinnamon.
Oh. And cinnamon too.
Yes, and you can just gobble them up. It's great.
Wow, all these good healthy things.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's great. Now this salad looks just divine.
And this is just a mixture of a spinach and arugula and a few other greens in here, a few nuts, a few almonds in there,
mm-hmm.
and you can use as your protein source either chicken or salmon or another fish on top, and it's a beautiful way to get the blueberries into a condiment for the entire meal. Now, this is a blueberry vinaigrette, which goes very beautifully on top of the salad and just adds another little dose of blueberries and another little zing to it. So
oh,
it's
that looks
really
delicious.
Great. It is. It's great.
Oh, my. And blueberries all day long?
If you can get them fresh, it's just easy to have them there just to pop like candy at your desk. And they're wonderful. I think that's a real advantage of blueberries compared to so many other foods that you know are good for you. Well, blueberries actually taste great as well. It's a treat.
Yeah.
So why not have them there just to have during the day?
Exactly. We cannot overeat with blueberries, can
we? You can't.
That's great. These all look wonderful.
Thanks.
Thank you.
The research on fruits and vegetables at the NC State University Plants for Human Health Instiute will enhance the health protective value of food crops. It also has the potential to increase the economic impact of North Carolina agriculture. Currently, the annual production value of blueberries to the North Carolina economy is more than $58 million. You can learn more about the Institute's research and cooperative extension programs at this website. For more information on fruits and vegetables, visit theproducelady.org.